Hey, get out! Welcome to Get Fact.
Hello.
Good morning.
I almost forgot what to do. I need to press a button there. I just can't remember which button. Yeah, good morning. This is unusual for us, isn't it?
It's an early one this day.
An early shift. We've got an early one next week as well. Oh, can't wait for that.
What time's that?
Same time.
Oh, not even had a coffee yet.
10 o'clock.
Got my coffee here waiting to...
Yes.
I need it.
I can't wait to talk to her. I've got so many weird questions.
That'd be interesting, though.
Like, they're not a normal question that you'd ask a singer. So.
We'll just leave that one there, shall we?
Yeah. I thought, do we tell him he's coming on or?
Oh yeah, I'd give him a heads up.
Give him a heads up.
Yeah.
I know, but, you know, James Maynard, he had a big guest on and kind of like left people guessing and then released it last minute. So I don't know if I'd do that or tell him.
I'd tell him.
Okay, well,
give him something
next week
to.
We're going to be chatting with Abby Flynn. You might not recognise the name. But she pretty much is the voice to a lot of like big dance songs at the minute, and she's only getting bigger by the day. I think she's going to be, you know, the next Becky Hill. I don't know if you've heard of her.
Becky Hill.
You have.
I have. Yeah.
See, I think she's going to be like her. You know, like finally getting a name on all the labels and that. But she deserves it. She's the voice.
You're the voice, cried understanding.
Who was that?
John Farnham.
I was going to say, that's not Becky Hill.
You need to get John Farnham on.
I tried, I messaged him.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, because I was singing my heart out to that song in the car. And I was like, who sings this? Never heard of him.
It's a quality song.
And then messaged him. He's got a few thousand followers, I think.
Is it?
Yeah, it's mad.
Get on, John.
Yeah, get on, John. Yeah. Can't wait. I'd love to speak to him, like, see what it was like back in the day.
Yeah.
Being that big.
I remember him being on an episode of Home and Away.
Right? Home and Away?
Yeah, he was on.
From that one song, was it?
He was on an episode of Home and Away around the time that song came out.
I was going to say, because I listened to a few of his other songs and I don't really recognise him. But that song is like a standard.
He was quite big in Australia.
Was he?
Yeah.
Right.
And when that song came out, that obviously broke him to the world.
Yeah.
And yeah, he was on an episode of. Home and Away.
So, is he Australian then, yeah?
I think he's Australian, yeah.
Right, they've got like a crude sense of humour, Australians.
They have, yeah.
So, that should be fun. Yeah. Let's get straight into it. Anyway, Russia have called ceasefire. Is Putin dead?
Ooh.
What do you reckon?
This is a conspiracy theory, is Putin
dead? It's my conspiracy.
I'd like to think he was dead.
Yeah, because I don't understand why they would. Why would they ceasefire?
I think it's just a case of they've given up. The world doesn't like them anymore.
I can't see Putin giving up. I think the only way they give up is when Putin dies.
I think he's been forced to give up.
You reckon?
Yeah.
He's forcing him.
Well, the thing
anyone
is,
that comes near him and tries to say anything.
The thing is, there's always someone in charge. And just because Putin's the president or whatever he is, I think when a group of his second-in-commands, I mean, they have a load of second-in-commands from different areas, and I think they can just all get together and say, look, you're going to have to call off.
I know, but I don't know if they'd listen. If Putin would listen.
Nothing?
No.
Yeah.
He's like Kim Jong-un, isn't he? Whatever his name is. I just made him sound like a hung horse. But yeah, it's like whenever someone steps in, he killed his own uncle, Kim Jong-un, or whatever. What's his name?
Kim Jong-un.
That's all. Hung. He's going to kill me. Yeah, but he killed his own uncle because he tried to, like, butt in to, like, the parliament and he's like, nope, kill him.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so it's like a warning shot to his own family members.
It probably is, like.
Yeah.
I think once that Kim Jong either steps down or dies, I think there'll be a massive change for North Korea.
Oh, definitely.
I think they'll become more allowed to do more because they're not allowed internet or anything.
Was
like that
the one where they're not allowed jeans?
Is that, not allowed to, that something like not allowed to wear jeans? Not allowed any outside influences other than what goes on in Korea.
Oh, yeah, you're also not allowed a mullet. I don't know. You have to have his hairstyle, roughly.
I think women have to wear skirts to a certain length.
That's mental.
Anything above and below that,
yeah,
probably a shot.
Yeah. Who was it that mentioned that on this? I don't know if it was on this podcast. That a country believe that they're winning the World Cup every year and stuff like that.
Wasn't it something like...
Because they just get told these things. They're not allowed outside information.
Wasn't it one of the, sort of the Saudi countries?
I'm not sure. Weird that though, isn't it?
Or it might have been even North Korea.
It's had a living in a bubble, isn't it?
Yeah. Or it might have even been North Korea.
What a life. That's scary, isn't it?
And those that have managed to get out have told people about what their life's like.
Yeah, yeah. They're
saying it's
I'm surprised they don't get killed.
Yeah.
Kill them. They must not know the secrets. Imagine that. You come out of that country thinking, like, you know, you're winning World Cups and stuff like that. You come out, you're like, oh, we're nothing. We've done nothing.
I know, yeah.
We've won, we don't even win the Olympics or anything.
Well, it'd be like...
it's been a while.
Stepping onto another planet, wouldn't it? Just occupied
go,
by...
Sorry. Go on then, Jack. Get out. You're doing me head in. Go on. Go on. You've been evicted. Making grails to try and be on a podcast.
Yeah, it'd be like trying to go and live on and find another alien planet and go step on it and be like, whoa, what's going on here?
Yeah, it would, wouldn't it?
All these aliens and stuff
that's
like that.
Exactly what it'd be like being a tribe as well, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Like,
because if you've had no contact,
yeah,
or very little contact with the outside world,
yeah,
and you're not allowed to use the internet, which I'm sure there's probably some people that do.
Yeah, definitely.
But for a kid growing up, with this in this bubble, to step out of that, it's going to be strange.
So I know they and countries do have internet, but it's really filtered.
Yeah,
like you can't go on a load of things. Like, hey, are they stopping that?
I don't know. I mean, maybe only certain
VPN.
Maybe of a certain people are allowed to use it,
right? Unless like the main internet supplies in them countries are literally capping it, so even a VPN won't work.
Maybe,
type thing.
Maybe,
I don't know.
Maybe.
Weird, scary world that.
It is.
Yeah, but there's some places that are like that as well, like in America. There's like towns that got their own rules and stuff.
Well, you've got the Amish towns.
Yeah.
They have their own rules. They
I don't remember where it is, but...
They don't have TV or radio.
Oh, that's weird. That's a different type of colony,
they don't even to have radio.
Radio, yeah. What's the purpose of that? Just to stop you...
It's just their own little sort of way of life. Yeah. So they don't get any... I think it's more to do with... There's nothing to influence... their traditions.
That was late. Save that, we'll have it as an effect.
Yeah, I think it's more to do with not allowed to have any sort of outside influences encroaching on their traditions and their values.
Yeah. But see, I don't really know much about Amish apart from that movie Kingpin. That's probably what I got all the information from.
You know, not allowed to have the photographs taken.
Yeah.
The only contact they have with the outside world is when they have to go into town for supplies.
Right.
And then people want to have the photographs taken with them.
It's a horrible life, though, isn't it? Because like, you get up out of bed and you work.
Yeah,
and
that's
then
it. It's just pure work.
You work
in religion.
Entertainment is reading a book, maybe.
Reading a book or dancing.
Yeah, dancing. Yeah, I wonder how you dance.
I don't know.
Did the Jew dance came to me then? That's not right. The Jews are at war at the moment, aren't they?
They are with the Gaza Strip.
With Iraq, is it?
Palestine.
Iran.
I think it's Palestine and Israel.
Israel, yeah. And we've sided with Israel, haven't we?
Yes.
We don't want to fight with the Jews.
Just don't need to fight at all.
Not yeah.
I mean, their war's been going on for, over 100 years.
Yeah, but they've kidnapped a lot of people, haven't they?
I don't know.
Yeah, there's loads of Americans kidnapped and stuff.
Wow.
I heard a story yesterday that they beheaded a pregnant woman.
That wouldn't surprise me.
What?
I mean, there's basically, apparently there's three factions. There's Israel, Palestine, and then there's like a third. Yeah. I can't remember who it is now.
Sick, but, though, isn't it?
Yeah. It's just...
So it's like, have you noticed there's not much news on the Russian war at the minute because of that war?
Yeah, it's been
like they don't know...
That's probably why Putin's... Well, the ceasefire, because he's like, well, hang on,
let's see what these do.
Why is no one looking at us?
I know, yeah. Oh,
ceasefire for us. Get this war over with.
Yeah.
We'll fire it back up.
Yeah, this little war. Yeah, get out of where. We want the highlight again. Something else about the Russian war, I can't remember. No, I'll leave that. Have you heard of the... Oh, have you ever heard of Gabby Tuft?
I haven't, no.
I think I showed you that picture of that wrestler. that turned into a girl, but I don't know if they're on the podcast.
No, I don't remember seeing that one.
You don't? Search it up so I can show you.
There you go.
I want a before and after. There you go. So that's what it was like before when she was when it was a wrestler. He. What'd you say? He, she, you what?
Them.
Because they'd be massive.
Massive, like Arnie. That's proper like that's like an Arnie build, that.
Yeah, proper like wrestling build. And then now it's like that. That's mental, isn't it? Look at the difference. A totally different person. It's like, what? How did you get from one extreme to another?
Where's all the arms have gone dead slim?
I know, it's weird, isn't it? So do you think that's got something to do with like, you know, steroids and stuff?
Yeah,
because I think it changes you, doesn't it?
Yeah,
because
well, the steroids mostly have got not all the steroids, but most of them have got male hormones in them.
Yeah, yeah.
So obviously testosterone and stuff like that, which builds you up. So if you stop taking that, he's probably gone on to taking probably estrogen tablets or something, which is a female hormone.
Yeah, yeah.
He probably then starts slimming down quicker. Right. He'd have had to have a bit of surgery to get rid of
a few
bits and pieces because he's lost his traps.
Yeah, he's lost everything. He's mad. I wouldn't say he's a bad-looking girl, either.
I wouldn't, actually. It's not too bad, that, actually.
Which is mad.
Well, then, what does he, she sound like now?
Talk like that. That's a good point. I've not heard. Gubby Alan Tuft. So if they use both names, though, like, did you call Alan Tuft and he changed to Gabby? Talking, let's see what he says. Other. I hope I don't get done for copyright here, using someone else's. I wonder if we can get him on the podcast.
Yeah, that'd be on a podcast, though, that'd be it? Interesting, wouldn't it?
There he is, the wrestler, though.
Yeah.
Massive.
I'm very, very happy. I feel like I have a prison sentence that just got out and I'm free.
Man, yeah, so talk to me about this. I mean, this is a huge deal for you. I mean, what is it like to let the world know that you're Gabby Tuft now?
It feels absolutely amazing. It's something I've been hiding for years, and it's gotten to the point where I just couldn't hold it inside anymore, and I don't know how much you have time for or want to know, but...
Bring it on.
So what did she say like before that?
That's what I was just going
to
say.
I'm curious to see if you have that.
Find something
before. I'm looking at you, sugar!
Or was it a case of, I'm looking at you, sugar.
Yeah. But I don't know what her name was before. Was it Alan, did it say?
Alan. Alan, wasn't it?
Tough.
Owen.
Was it? Right, is there any work there? That looks like it's...
Try that one.
All right, guys, so you've probably noticed that my Facebook page has
that's
been
mad.
Different than you're used to over the last...
Whoa, that's well, my it's like a different
and
person.
It's because I've been very, very passionate about what I'm posting. But along the line, I kind of noticed that I'm not even following my own advice here. And I have been not necessarily spreading negative stuff.
Gabby and Priscilla joined.
Well,
and you did not been living your... What's like age 4 years?
It became one of those things where
that's weird, isn't it?
Culture just beat it into
that's
my head.
That's obviously got to do with the hormones.
Yeah, because I can't imagine you putting that voice on all the time. That'd be
it works the other way when women bodybuilders take steroids with.
They get deep voices, don't they?
They get deep voices. They get Adam's apples and certain parts.
Did they get Adam's apples?
Some of them do. Yeah,
how's that?
Because the voice goes deeper, the Adam's apples has to stretch. To accommodate.
So I don't even know what an Adam's apple is. So
it's that lump in your throat there.
Yeah, but I mean, what? How's that formed?
It's your voice box.
I thought it was like another part of
your voice box that holds your vocal cords. Yeah. So as it to enable it for men's voices to go deeper, it has to grow to stretch the vocal cords to make the low resonance sound.
Right.
Whereas women's doesn't stretch that much, so they keep a higher range.
Yeah. But I've heard like people like with massive Adam's apples with like low pitched voices, like
yeah,
It's like, whoa!
I don't know what's happened there.
Yeah, he swallowed his apple too
much.
But
women who take the steroids with testosterone in it, like, they'll go deeper voices. Some will grow Adam's apples. The faces will change to look more manly. And certain parts of their anatomy grow a little bit as well.
Jesus Christ. I've got scientists on today.
I love biology, see, so.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
Oh, you'd have a nice chat with Adele, and she did biology in university.
Oh, did she?
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic. So, yeah, I like biology. Not that I'm did any good at school with it, but.
Are you good at the chart?
The biology chart? Yeah. What's the biology chart?
The
periodic table.
The periodic table.
No, that's chemistry, that.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
No, man. I was going to get it out. I think Oliver's got one somewhere. See, no, if we need the letters.
Chemistry, I never got my head around. I never really got my head around physics. Biology, yeah.
Okay. Floor is falling apart in Turkey. Have you seen
that?
That's
with all these earthquakes in that.
Yeah, have you seen it?
No.
It's scary. I'll get a stare to this. That's scary, isn't it?
Yeah.
Imagine, that is a pothole, isn't it?
It is, isn't it?
It's that speak, that. Have you seen the road at the moment?
Yeah,
I hope that's not finished. Look at that! That's a lot of work just gone, that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Where's it going?
Well, I believe that could be a natural phenomenon happening, like it's happened over all the millions of years, where continents shifted and moved to create the landmass changed. I think that could be a part of that. That's what's happening, the landmass is changing.
Yeah, so I think it's like open it up, like the earth's opened a bit and it's just all of it's just gone down. Well, look at that. That's weird, isn't it? They're heavy, them. What's that about, that last bit?
No idea. I think someone's going to shoot out and fire his jacket back up. But yeah, I think that's what's happening, continental shifts, changing the land formation.
Right.
It happened over millions of years, and it's still happening now. Volcanoes are still erupting, creating new landmass.
Yeah. Earthquakes are weird, aren't they? Like, they literally crack. It's basically the earth cracking.
Yeah.
It's weird.
It's what it is.
It goes down dead far as well. If you fall down, you're dead. We're in a brew already. The world's falling apart. We're not helping. We're going to blow the world up.
Well, we probably helped with all the explosions and everything.
Yeah.
We've done all those nuclear bomb tests and it's probably not helped.
Yeah. Did I tell you about that theory where, like, about the Big Bang theory?
Nope.
Where the conspiracy could be that we get to a certain point where we have all these nuclear weapons that we actually blow ourselves up and then we restart and we get to this point every time. So that's what could have happened millions, because Earth's millions of years old.
So do you think...
So civilizations could get to the point where we're at now, we just blow each other up.
So the dinosaurs kind of wiped themselves out, but got wiped out with a huge explosion.
Yeah.
Eventually we came along, mammals and humans came along. But then we'll get wiped out and a new civilization will start after us.
Yeah, do you reckon it'd be the same as us? Or?
No, they'd be different, because we're not the same as dinosaurs, are we?
No, but what's to say we didn't live with dinosaurs?
I think a lot of science has proven that we didn't live with dinosaurs.
Does it? Have they?
Although some have, the crocodiles and a few lizards that are related to dinosaurs.
Yeah, how old dinosaurs are? That's a long time.
Hundreds of billions of years.
Dinosaurs? Are they?
Yeah.
Well, that's what I mean. So we've had loads of civilizations probably happen after that.
Yeah, we've had time to evolve.
I mean, we could have blew ourselves up loads and loads of times after that.
Probably could.
Because we're idiots.
Maybe.
I think we get to a point where we're too clever and it's like, we all just need to reset.
I think, you're right. I think we do need to reset.
Yeah.
I think we need to get rid of some of these warmongers.
Oh, definitely.
Who are just purposely trying to start wars.
Yeah, well they're on about getting an AI government, aren't they, in the future?
That'd be interesting.
Which will be, non-biased. They'll know what's best for humans.
That'd be interesting.
Yeah.
There's your next phase, AI. All the humans get wiped out, AI comes along.
Well, that's the thing.
It takes over.
I mean, you can't... Yeah, when it gets that clever, AI, you can't really argue with what it says. If it says, you need to blow that country up because that country's going to cause harm to everyone else, you can't deny it, because if it knows what's going to come
but is it, based on everything. Be right, though? Because we can sort of overthink things.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
So we decide, like, well, all right, then we're
going to... But can't because of this and this. Yeah, but you don't know the bigger outcome.
Yeah.
I'm seeing it because I've got all the data.
Yeah, yeah. Interesting.
Would we then argue with it and go, no, shut it down, restart it?
Would it allow you to shut it down?
Oh, you get to a point where it's like, nah.
Would it already know that and think it's going to shut me down? Let's stop that.
Yeah, you'll get that little guy on there, Jurassic Park.
You didn't say the magic word.
Yeah. But yeah, this is going to be a scary time. It's coming. They're saying it's like next 10 years, isn't it? It's
it wouldn't be surprise like me, to be honest with you.
AI things. Or
technology is moving rather fast.
Yeah. I know chat on about AI a lot on the show, but I love it.
If it's used in the right way, then yeah, it's a good idea.
Well, like ChatGPT, I think that's a good good example. That reminds me, I've not got nothing for that, but I can always get it on break. On break time.
Break.
Yeah. Dubai is working on a 1,200-mile underwater train that goes to India that goes 1,000 kilometres per hour.
Underwater.
That sounds dangerous.
I'm giggling because I've just seen the next section.
Stop reading it. I made the writing small so you couldn't read it. I mean, make it smaller.
You can't say that. Anyway, back to the train.
Yeah.
Underwater, yeah. Going 1,000 kilometres an hour. So what's 1,000 kilometres? About 700 miles an hour, something like that?
Yeah, it's fast.
That's underwater.
That's underwater, yeah. How is that possible? You're going to be like a missile.
It would have to be. You'd have to have all the...
It's one of torpedoes. How fast is a torpedo?
That's what I mean, because you've got all the water pressure.
Let's have a look. How fast is a torpedo? If it's faster than a torpedo, I don't believe it's possible. What's that? 50 kilohertz?
50 kTr.
What? Destroy target at a range of... What's 50 kilohertz? Is it different than the water or something?
Yeah, how fast is a torpedo in mile per hour?
230 mile per hour. Three times faster than a torpedo.
It's got to be a structural thing as well for the pressure of the water.
Yeah. How low is it? It can't be at the bottom.
How much underwater is it going to be?
It can't be at the bottom. It'll be loads of pressure. So it'll be in the middle, floating. He's making the... That's not going to work, is it?
You've got to put a train track in there as well.
Yeah.
Or some kind of track.
Yeah, but not just that. It's like, what's it floating on?
Like, well, I would presume there'd be bedrock.
I wouldn't
want to do it in Turkey right at the moment.
Yeah, I know, I saw that.
Bedrock's disappearing. I know,
yeah. But I can't see. Let's have a see if they've got pictures or ideas of it. Where was it again? India?
Dubai? Yeah.
Dubai underwater train. Hotel?
Oh yeah, they got a hotel looking.
Underwater. Oh,
yeah, there you go.
It's got a little fin and everything. It's just like on one rail thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just on one rail, isn't it?
Yeah. Like a roller coaster.
It's a monorail. It'd be interesting, like. How it does look like it's that deep underwater, though.
No, it's quite... It's quite...
So if it's on a monorail, then it... Well, it's the monorail's still got to be fastened to something, though.
Yeah. But, I mean, would you trust the pressure? Like, if that starts leaking...
Well, it's not...
You're dead?
Well, it's not exactly deep underwater, though, is it?
It's still if that starts leaking in.
Well, it starts leaking in, yeah, but there's probably going to be safety features, too.
And you're going to jump out at 700 mile an hour.
Well, no, I'm sure there's probably some safety features in there that will raise it to the top. If any of the seals go.
It's going to some last string, though, that looks like it's going straight through the train.
It might have, like, an ejector thing on it. So.
Just shoot you out the water.
Just
700 miles
an hour. Shoot itself out of one.
See people flying.
Shoot out like a torpedo. That's why it's called the torpedo train.
Yeah. People just flying out.
AI gets all of that.
Oh, yeah.
So it's fighting these, like, humans as torpedoes.
Yeah. But what, you know, like... roller coasters, they get stuck at top and stuff sometimes. So what if that just gets stuck underwater?
Well, yeah.
He's fixing that. He's just drawing. I wouldn't be trusting that anyway. Not unless it's been around for about 10 years.
We'll see how long it lasts. See how many accidents.
It's like I wanted to be on the first airplane either. So until that's safe. That must have been scary, isn't it? The first airplane. Like,
yeah.
Jump on it. Trust me, it's going to work.
Did you see it?
No.
The first sort of man flight.
It was like a bicycle tire or something. It's like running
guy
or someone pedaling.
Guy on a bike.
Yeah, someone pedaling. Little wings made out of paper. They're mad, aren't they?
Like, crazy.
It's going to work, it's going to work. If it doesn't, I'm dead, but let's go. It's weird. Yeah, go on. Look, what was this that you laughed at night next to us? I always...
I can't... let's translate that then. So
No, I'll say it. Because it's a film. Did you know that?
Is this a film?
It's a film.
Really?
So there's a film out there. It's called Gay Niggas from Outer Space. Now, I can say that because I'm just announcing a film.
Right, okay.
So,
well, that, yeah,
if I search... I won't say too many times, like, but... if I search it in...
Gay black people from outer space.
No, unless it's a... There it is. 1992, it's a movie.
Who's in it? The 1992 short film. Easy, yeah. Extraterrestrials, Travel the Galaxy.
Hang on, let's have a look at the Wikipedia. The plot though. Read this bit.
The film shows a group of intergalactic homosexual black men from the planet Anus who discover the presence of female creatures on the planet Earth. Using ray guns, they proceed to eliminate the females one by one from Earth, eliciting gratitude from previously oppressed male population. Before leaving the planet, they leave behind a gay ambassador to educate Earthlings about the new way of life.
That's mad, isn't it? How did they get away with that?
Crazy film.
That's mental. 5.8 rating as well. I'm surprised they didn't get one. Hey, do you reckon the world would live without women on it?
Terribly.
Do you reckon?
Yeah.
Why? What's your reason behind that?
Because I like women.
Okay. Fair point.
Well, this is...
Well, I mean, run-wise, I mean, without the, you know, physical attraction.
Well, I think women have a different perspective on life, don't they?
Yeah, I think they do, yeah.
We just think...
Yeah, get in there, I think they do grind us a bit, don't they? Mm. Keep us level-headed.
I think they do, yeah.
Because male, we're all like, I want to fight. But that's how we sort things out.
Yeah, women just like you.
They'll just argue for days.
Women cause the argue.
Yeah.
End up us men fighting.
Yeah. That's right, yeah.
Men just that was a joke, by the way. I'm not.
Oh, you're a feminist,
sexist,
aren't you?
Not being sexist.
I'd have said that the right word, the feminist. Is that against females or against, with them?
Feminists for female.
For female. Yeah. Oh, so you're not a feminist. You're opposite. You're an anti-feminist.
I'm pro-feminist.
Talking about females, female frogs fake their own death to avoid unwanted attention from male study fans.
I can believe that, actually.
So, well, women do it, don't they? They pretend to be asleep. Oh, got a headache.
Women have headaches.
Yeah. But frogs pretend to be dead. That won't work with men. Just, some men like that. It's a fetish.
Maybe some frogs do as well.
I know, yeah. My puppy definitely is set humping it. Yeah, that's weird, isn't it?
Yeah, but I can't believe that.
One of the largest pyramids in the world is actually a Bass Pro shopping centre.
A Bass Pro?
Yeah.
What's a Bass Pro
shop? So, like, you know, bass.
A bass guitar?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I'll show you now. Pyramid Bass Pro. It's the 9th biggest pyramid in the world.
Oh, right, so it's not an official pyramid.
It's a shopping centre pyramid.
Right, okay.
But it's officially the 9th biggest.
Right.
It's weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
How many people go to that?
I thought it's an actual pyramid.
I've seen, like, little base shops shut down because no one's buying it.
So it's called the Bass Pro Shopping Centre.
Hmm. How many people are buying guitars over there?
It's like a glorified shopping city.
It is. It's cool, though. That looks like it belongs in Dubai. They always have like
Memphis. Oh, it's in Memphis.
Yeah,
America.
Mad. It's cool. Somewhere you'd like that.
Look at the size of that inside it.
At that.
Wow. Yeah.
Oh, that's cool, isn't it? Oh yeah.
It's alright though.
I don't mind visiting that. It's pretty cool. Oh, they've got loads of things in there.
The food.
Yeah. What's that? Vince Bucks fish bowl. Oh, it's bowling and food. Nice. Looks good. I thought it was just for like buying guitars. I thought it was well going to be boring inside.
That looks all right though.
Doesn't it? I've just got a new one that's been found in China.
A new one, what?
I don't have a clue. I've not wrote down what it is. I think it's metal. Oh, that's what it is. A new ore has been found out, but a new one. Yeah, I think it's spelling mistakes changed it to one. A new one has been found. A new ore containing invaluable rare metal has been found in China.
So what's the rich in...
What is that? What are you reading?
That's it. Niobium. Never heard of niobium.
Niobiotite.
Or is rich in niobium, a highly sought after metal with superconductive properties.
Superconductive.
Ooh.
So is it going to be used for like electrical items and stuff like that, I assume?
Possibly.
National nuclear. I don't like the sound of nuclear.
Oh, here we go.
I don't like that. It's rare that we find new stuff, isn't it?
Niobium is used as an additive in alloys such as steel to improve their strength. Owing to its resistance to corrosion and heat, metals containing niobium are commonly used in things like rockets,
nice,
oil pipelines, and jet engines. In the US, practically all fighter jets are made of niobium alloys.
Right.
Right, okay.
That's pretty cool, isn't it? So what's
they just found another...
different version of it, type thing.
I'd say they found just another load of it.
Oh, is that it?
Niobium ore, yeah.
Oh, right. How far is it? Like a new metal they found? Is that right?
I've never heard of niobium.
Have you not?
But I'm not a chemist.
Yeah, but
I'm
why?
A biologist.
Why did he always come up with like weird words for it?
I know.
That's hard for us common people to say.
Yeah.
Is it because it's like, no, this is our thing, you have to learn how to say it before you can ask?
Adamantium.
Everything got ium on the end as well, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Aluminium.
Oh, sorry.
Titanium.
Aluminum.
Aluminum. Yeah, that's an Aluminium, isn't it?
Whereas we just say tinfoil.
Yeah. What do you do if a service dog approaches you on its own wearing its little vest? That's a question to you.
What do you do if a service dog approaches you on its own wearing its little vest?
Yeah.
Do you like a police dog? Guide dog?
It's just
any service dog.
So it's just a service dog on the vest, and it's like a little. What do you do?
Find out what service it's working for. I wouldn't say working for, but it's part of, and contact them and say, I've got one of your dogs here.
Right. So the actual answer is you actually follow it because it wants you to follow him because the owner's fell over or something.
Oh, right.
And it's injured. So that's mad, isn't it? They're clever, isn't it? So go and get a human and be like, follow me type thing, come on. It's that Lassie, innit?
Yeah.
Just can't say it.
little Harry's down the well.
Yeah, that's what it means. I seen a poster the other day saying like, more people need to know this because like...
Well, that should have been done years ago when we started training guide dogs and stuff like that.
Yeah, the rules should have come in.
Implied that for the public as well.
Yeah, yeah, so that people know.
That's the first time I've ever heard of that.
Yeah, that's same. I seen it as like, oh, no way. It's like...
Because most people...
I would have just came over that. Oh, hello. Oh,
hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
Where's your owner? Oh, you little cutie.
Oh, let's go and phone someone.
Let's go take your vets. For your owner. Owner's dead.
Little Johnny's dead down the way.
Yeah, he died. But yeah, it's interesting to know, isn't it? Oh, they found Bigfoot.
Oh, here we go. Where have they found him?
Yeah. There's him.
Oh.
See, there's a little video, I think. He is walking there.
This is crazy.
There he is. Bigfoot. Sitting down, having a munch. Hey, why are these videos always like dead far away or unclear and stuff?
Exactly. I think this is computer generated.
This year now, we can zoom in by times 100 on a Samsung phone.
Yeah.
I could have looked at his pupil. So
this is
from there.
Obviously like a drone footage by the look of it.
It looked kind of like a train going by, like he's on a train or something, the way it moves. Or maybe it was a drone.
I think it's some kind of drone. So why didn't whoever's flying the drone
get closer?
Maybe they didn't see it, but
what
no, that looks like someone's added using computers.
Yeah, I don't believe that. Like,
couple sees Bigfoot.
What is that?
On the video.
Oh, I was reading. Travelling along in Durango and Silverton Railroad on October 8th.
Oh, you're right, I was on a train.
Was it? And another person spotted something sulking along among the grass. What a... Why would you put them two words together?
So you can...
Yeah, that's a weird word, isn't it?
Sulking along.
Sulking along among the grass.
I say skulking.
Skulking?
Yeah.
Why?
Don't know.
Is that what you said?
That's how I say it. I don't say sulking.
Is that like sulking and skriking together?
I don't know.
Do you use that word? Skriking.
Skulking along there.
Have you ever used that word, skriking?
Skriking, no. A couple of times.
Skrike. Stop skriking.
Yeah.
That's a weird word. That's a word that isn't used anymore. I've never heard that.
Well, skriking.
Wait, 10 years? Yeah, but I don't believe that.
I think that's computer animated.
A load of cads wallocks.
A load of waffle.
Yeah. Sphere. Trolls the golfer. Remember we were talking about the sphere? Is that, am I saying that right? Sphere.
Sphere.
Sphere. Here it is. It looks like he's like accommodated to him.
Oh, I don't think he likes it. All right. He doesn't like it at all.
That's mad, Danny.
Yeah. That's that building, isn't it?
Yeah, that big sphere.
Yeah.
That's cool, that though, isn't it? Like, is it by chance that he's done that? He's very on cue, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's by chance.
It's mad, that. Do you reckon it keeps doing it over and over and they've gone?
Possibly.
No.
Right, it's time this and...
Time, yeah. Pretty good, though.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
Well, the new Halloween one. I love it, me. I'm obsessed with this sphere, me.
So if anyone's listening, go onto YouTube and have a look under the sphere in Las Vegas.
Yeah, it's just...
This is an amazing building that hosts all kinds of events. And it's just absolutely fantastic. It's amazing.
Yeah, it is. It's hypnotic almost.
I mean, look at that.
We need some of them over here.
We do. I don't think it'll be long. I think they will get some.
Imagine if houses were like that. Every house had a little like...
That'd be ace, that wouldn't it?
Massive TV. You can just change what your house looks like.
Yeah.
Every day if you want to.
Great, wouldn't it? Yeah.
It'd be mad. But like, what happens if it smashes that?
You'd have to spend loads on decorations as well. You can say, I want a Christmas house.
Yeah. That'd be cool, wouldn't it? But I mean,
so you program it to do a Christmas house.
If it smashes though, that sphere, like what is it, bulletproof glass that or what?
It'd probably be toughened glass, I should imagine, because it'd have to withstand a lot of weather.
Yeah, and it goes all the way to the bottom, so if someone throws like a beer bottle at it and it smashes, imagine that cracking all the way.
It's probably under some kind of toughened glass.
Yeah,
the actual imagery is so. under glass.
Yeah, but it might be also them micro LEDs we were talking about. I don't know if you was on that one. I think it was Tom and Dan.
Might have been.
So it's like little screens with like loads of mini.
Yes, I've seen. Tom sent you a video or something, didn't he?
Yeah.
They all clipped
together. But I'm guessing that could have been used. Because if one bit breaks, you're going to swap it out.
Well, I think this is the future of a lot of things.
What?
That's this micro
LED.
LED sort of visual thing.
Definitely.
With your TV, you probably end up with a micro LED TV.
Yeah.
That just looks like your wall.
Yeah.
Until you switch it on.
You switch it on.
And your wall turns into a TV.
Definitely.
Watch Arnold Schwarzenegger. Commando.
Remember when the first TVs was like input in walls?
Yeah.
But like, there was like them big back ones.
Yeah.
So it looked flush from the front.
Yeah.
And they'd be all right back. You see a massive telly at the opposite side of the wall.
It's about 6 foot telly at the
TV
back.
TV sticking out. Bloody hell. The first flat screen TVs, eh? Girls are now getting eyebrow extensions. Have you seen that?
Eyebrow extension? Haven't they been doing that anyway? With false eyelashes. That's a false extension, isn't it?
No, but this is silly.
This is a surgical one.
No. This is like a new trend. So, you know, you get the big lips and stuff. Like, that's a trend.
Yeah.
So, apparently, this is going to be the next thing. It looks ridiculous. Hang on. These? So, like, they extended them, like, dead long. But I don't know what's... I think, obviously, they trim it and make it neat, but...
Well, the thing is, I can probably understand that because a lot of women, my partner is one that her eyebrows have thinned out so much that she has to sort of pencil them in.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Right.
I mean, she doesn't go over the top like having a scouse brow or anything like that.
Yeah,
but that's, I think that's to help people who, I mean, some people have lost them through having some kind of, you know, if they've got cancer and they've had
alopecia and stuff like that.
Yeah, and so they've lost them through natural causes. Right, but yeah, I kind of, it's a good idea.
Yeah, but
I can imagine some scousers
overdoing it
and you're having the famous scouse brow.
Definitely. Well, it started off ages ago. Everyone wanted skinny eyebrows, didn't they? Like little pretty much lines, wasn't it?
Because the more you pluck your eyebrows, the less they're going to grow back.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was one of the reasons why my missus.
Right.
Hasn't got much in the eyebrows.
Right.
So, yeah.
Yeah, but I think you have to have some kind of eyebrow to actually be able to do that because they're attaching fake hair to it, aren't they?
Well, is it that the case or is it because you can have hair transplant, can't you?
Right.
So is it the same sort of idea? Well,
I've seen them...
As long as the follicles there?
Right, I've seen that there was basically like attaching hair to hair.
Right.
Like a hair extension type thing.
I'm with you.
But it's dead long. It's longer than that. I've seen it. It was like full on head hair length.
Looks like when they put it on. A wolf man or something like that.
Doesn't it? But imagine keeping that and just walking around town. Like spiked.
Kill it.
Yeah. Be well cool.
You see all these women going round on the nights out when they go shopping, they've still got the curlers in the hair.
Oh, it's ridiculous.
Imagine them with curlers in their eyebrows.
That looks awful.
That's a scouse brow.
That's a proper scouse brow, that. Awful. Have you seen the Russian eyelashes?
No.
Oh, they're shocking, them. They're basically eyebrows on your eyelashes. It's terrible. Proper, like, caterpillars.
Yeah, Russian eyelash extensions.
There's some that... They're all right, them ones. There's the thicker ones. There's, like, proper thick ones. That's ridiculous. Jesus. Imagine blinking.
Could you open your eyes? You'd
flap off, wouldn't you? That looks painful to me.
You can see the original eyelashes underneath.
Yeah, you can.
They're just
kind
of just sitting on top.
They're almost curled. They're awful.
Things women do.
I know, it's crazy, isn't it? But it's,
grow old naturally and gracefully.
But it goes through a phase, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Like, it's good, it's the next big thing, and then that'll die out, and then something else will come along.
Yeah.
Do we have anything like that, men? We just have hairstyles, don't we, and beards?
Yeah.
We don't really go white all like extreme.
I can see my chin. I'm growing my chin now.
Are you growing your chin, not your beard?
I'm growing my chin. I can't grow a beard.
You're growing your chin.
I'm growing my chin. Not my actual chin. The bone structure's still the same.
You're going to come in with one of proper long bum chins, aren't you? Like an American. Hey there, you're under arrest. Like a proper American police chin, isn't it? Terror attack in Euros qualifier. So he shot it dead in a stadium. What the fuck I've put? Yes or no? People are. People are terrorizing football stadiums, shooting people. Have they got a gun in?
Well, they're probably in some stadiums. It's probably just easy. You just walk in some stadiums. Not a lot of people get searched. I mean, I went to see Barcelona a few years ago.
Yeah.
I never got searched.
Really?
Walk straight in with tickets. Yeah. I could have had anything in my top.
So it was Belgium.
I had a bag of crisp.
You did? Yeah. You had a bag of crisp with a bomb in it. Qualifier abandoned at half time after two people shot dead in Brussels before kickoff. Belgian authorities raised terror alert to its highest level in the capital.
Belgium?
Mm?
Wow. That's unusual. Belgium's quite a peaceful nation.
Is it?
Yeah.
And Sweden as well?
Sweden's. So Sweden. Is it Sweden or Switzerland who's the neutral country?
Switzerland, isn't it? Yeah. They don't want nowhere.
They want nothing with no one. I don't blame them.
That's how it should be. I'd love to move to Switzerland. I can't even talk today. Well, that's the place
where they... If I had the money, I'd do it.
That's the place where they pay you to live there, isn't it?
Is it?
50 grand a year.
Is it? Wow.
Yeah, but that's a certain town because the town's dying out.
Yeah.
People are getting old.
I'd live there. I'd live there if I had to live in a bin. I wouldn't care.
Live in a bin.
It's a beautiful country. Never been, but from what I've seen, it's a beautiful country.
It is. It's like house on top of house, isn't it? It's madder than mad.
All that countryside as well.
Let's have a quick look at Switzerland. Switzerland. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking of, that type of thing. It's like all houses.
Well, that's like...
There's only mountains with houses on as well, isn't there?
Yeah.
That is type of thing. That looks nice in winter, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Proper little winter wonderlands. Look at that.
Is that... That looks like that town where they pay you to live.
Could be.
I'm sure that's it.
We type in Swiss town where you pay to live or something like that.
That was it there, then.
Did look a bit run down, that, didn't it?
That one.
Oh, no, it doesn't look that bad, actually.
So, they're willing to pay you 50 grand to live there.
But how much does it cost to live there, though?
Yeah.
Because it's an expensive country.
Is it?
Yeah.
Right. I didn't know that. But, I mean, 50 grand's quite a bit. But it depends if you can... What?
Is 50 grand a lot of money in their country, though?
I don't know, but it doesn't look like as much... I mean, there's not harvesting
much,
to do.
There's not much there, is there?
No, there's like, is there any food there to survive?
But I'd still live there. I don't know, just get deliveries.
Deliveries from where?
Go and Asda shopping. Asda shop.
Imagine Just Eat going to there.
Get Asda to deliver.
Yeah. Talking about Just Eat, actually, and delivering, I've got, might be on my articles here, somewhere. Jump to it. Stop looking at some guy that worked for Domino's,
yeah,
right, delivered a pizza on top of Mount Fuji. It took him 6 hours to climb the mountain and delivered the pizza to the guy at the top.
Did he get it handed back saying it's cold?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Did he even get a tip?
Not delivering there again.
I know, yeah. Freezing his pizza. That's some dedication, isn't that?
That's...
But if he said top of Mount Fuji, he'd be like, shut off. But he's like, I accept this challenge.
Unless he's done it like that, I accept this challenge. I'm getting it before the pizza's cold.
It's 6 hours. Well, it's 6 hours out of your work, isn't it?
Well, does that.
And you're still
well.
Getting paid for it. Yeah. And it's a nice hike. So I don't blame him.
Cool.
If you like hiking,
yeah,
paid for a hike.
Was he on one of them little scooters?
yeah, went back. Pizza. All the way up, mate. Fuji on that more bed. Yeah. That would have been class. Mickey Mouse Parliament.
That's what we've got right now.
Yeah, well, EU train to Strasbourg takes wrong turn, ends up in Disneyland. Did you see that?
Nice.
Or like the big political leaders and that end up in Disneyland instead.
I think they actually really wanted to.
Yeah, I think they did, yeah. Well, there's like videos of them talking, saying like, I could see the roller coaster, I wanted to get out, but it were delayed. Yeah. Stuff like that. Yeah. I didn't know they did that, but all like the big leaders onto one train. Apparently they've got their own train.
Right, okay.
And that's what that is, that one train is just for them leaders.
Right.
And they've got their own track for it and stuff.
Nice feeling, isn't it?
But I mean, I thought they didn't do that because if that blows up, all the leaders are gone.
Is that as well?
Yeah. Because they even stopped football players going on a plane together because when that plane crashed, you know, the Manchester United.
But unless they stick them all on, they've all had a conference and they take them all back. Maybe.
Still, I thought they'd have to.
I don't know.
I thought they'd have to be like one.
Unless the conference was on the train.
yeah, like a proper Bosch train.
Yeah.
I'd love that type of train. I mean, that's better than first class train, though. A permanent train.
I'd love to go on the Orient Express.
Is that a real thing?
Yeah.
I thought it was just a film.
No, it's the real thing.
Right. And is it like Christmassy? Have they done it on Christmassy?
No, it's not Christmassy. It's it's just a posh train that goes across.
Is it?
I don't even know where it goes from, actually.
What's it look like inside?
Posh.
What is it? Orient Express?
The Orient Express.
Oh, that is posh, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That is fun. I want to go on it now. How much is it?
Have a look.
Vanity Fair.
It's expensive. Yeah.
We do a podcast on Orient Express.
Oh, that'd be good, that, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
There's us two sat there with all these posh people around.
Oh, that'd be hilarious. And we'd get some on. So, how have you got your money? Would you try and put a voice on?
I got mine in oil. No. I've grown my chin, especially for this.
Would you just use your normal voice or try and blend in?
I'd use my normal voice.
I'd try and blend in for a laugh.
I'd say, you accept me for who I am.
Yeah. I'm going to say, Wilfred, how are you today? No. Yeah. Price.
Hold on, let me just get on my mobile talking device. Sell.
My telephone communication device.
Sell. Ticket.
There it is.
When do you want to go?
When? Yeah. No. Go. This month. Oh, they've sent
No, I don't want to inquire.
I just want to...
Go back to the search.
Yeah. Price estimate. How much?
Exactly.
We're not doing a podcast on there, are we? 2,920 quid. Well, and that's not a bad seat.
Well, when Memfresh eventually sponsors.
Yeah. Unless Orient Express wants to sponsor us and we can get them for free.
Hint.
Yeah. That's mad, isn't it? He's petting that.
Yeah, nearly $3,000 to go for a... I don't know how long you stay on this.
So you can get a better ticket for like $10,000? Oh, no, that's dollars, isn't it?
Eight grand. A twin cabin, that is.
Yeah. Is that the train they used on Harry Potter?
No.
What was that then?
I think that was just a...
It's a bog standard train, that.
It's a
cute little train, that. Little red thing.
I think they've done it up.
Right.
Some of it was probably CGI as well.
Probably, yeah. And we'll get to the end of this segment and then we'll go and make a brew. China built a 250-acre solar farm shaped like a giant panda.
Good on them.
Yeah, they love pandas over there, don't they? Well, they're proper obsessed with pandas.
Yeah, that's the...
What are they going to do when they die out because they're not having sex? They'd be guilty, wouldn't they? How cool is that?
That's brilliant, that.
That's a lot of effort, isn't it?
That's a lot of effort gone into that.
How cool would that look like on a plane?
A bit of efficiency, isn't it?
That'd look cool on a plane, that.
It would. That's a solar farm, is it? A whole lot.
Yeah.
Good the way they've done that.
It is, isn't it?
Good on them as well.
Yep. One step in the right direction for China.
Energy, yeah. Conserving energy.
Exactly that. Rocket has set off to capture asteroid. The asteroid's ore is believed to be worth a staggering 10,000 quadrillion, making everyone on Earth a billionaire.
Okay.
So
how are they
going
to capture it?
Even if we all became billionaires, there's still going to be trillionaires.
There's always going to be someone.
It'll just be the same situation.
So if me and you become billionaires or millionaires, you'll have someone, we'll just be like how we are now, but...
So a cup of tea will cost more, like a billion for a cup of tea or something, wouldn't it?
You're going to Starbucks.
$10,000 for a cup of tea. Hey, much?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
I'll have a...
It just doesn't make sense, does it?
A latte with whatever. Yeah, it's $40,000.
At that point, money becomes silly, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's, the numbers are getting higher, but everything's becoming higher.
I want to know how they're going to capture it, though.
I don't know. It
sends someone up with a big net.
They probably have one of them ships like that'll just put outside of it and then like cling to it. And it'll just redirect it to wherever it wants.
Oh, there's someone going to hang out the window with a big net.
Yeah, big net and catch it.
How big is the asteroid?
I'm not sure. But it's got to be quite big if it's worth all that money. Is it one big rock worth all that?
I presume it is.
And, you know, if you have so much of something, it becomes less worth it.
Well, the thing is, though, to catch... Rocket set off to capture an asteroid.
Yeah.
There's going to be someone behind that who thinks I'm going to make a lot of money from this.
Yeah. So...
And then you're going to get all these governments who are going to want a part of that.
Right.
And then... So I don't think everyone will become a billionaire.
I think they're estimating it, aren't they? Saying like they could.
I mean, how is it going to make me and you a billionaire?
Exactly. We have no say in it, do we?
No.
So...
Yeah. So it's going to be those who...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So... Back to AI a second. While we're talking about billions and stuff, people are worrying about the jobs and that, you know, for AI. But apparently, they're going to so every job that AI takes over and says doing, apparently they're going to put that into a system and everyone will get shares.
Right.
And you'll get, so let's say AI is now doing every job. You'll be able to stay at home, being a human, doing whatever you want, but still be getting paid the same amount as you was getting paid.
Okay.
That's what the plan is.
That'd be a good idea.
That'd be good.
I'm quite interested in that one.
That'd be good.
I'm happy to stay at home.
Yeah, and let the robots do my work as long as I'm getting paid. Because the money's still there, isn't it?
I think with all this AI stuff as well, I mean, you get all these film strikes and all these people on strike to do with the writers and stuff like that because of AI.
Mm.
I think now's the time for someone who, it's probably going to be the wrong thing to say, but on the back of that, to make a film using AI.
Right.
To release a film. Someone like you sit on here on your computer now and make an AI film, whole lot pure AI, and release it.
Using fake people or real people.
Fake.
Faces like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Just
and
make faces up. get the AI to generate new faces.
Apparently you can't.
Can you?
Because every face has already been made, apparently.
Okay.
So that's why people look like other people. Because every face is already made.
We'll just put fish heads on them or something like that.
Yeah, make them completely different. There's got to be some like change you can do, like make their eye a bit higher than the other. Yeah,
probably they'll be able to do tweak it in some way.
Yeah, make them have two noses.
Let's try and make an AI film.
Yeah, right. How did you do that?
I don't know.
Search it into AI, make me a film. It'll just do it for you, won't it?
The parameters, it's got to be an action film, got to have axes in it that get thrown.
Yeah, it's going to be scary though, because kids could cheat test now, can't they?
Yeah.
And so,
well, just like, yeah, this is where you need to start getting some kind of control on it.
Yeah, because you can just, you can literally ask Alexa almost to give you like a full script of what you need.
This is what I said before, is if it gets in the wrong hands, if it's used in the right way, then
yeah.
Use AI to help people, not.
Yeah. Have you seen the statue of Dwayne Johnson?
No.
Oh, it's a terrible. Is the wrong race or a start? Look at this. Where is it? Oh, where's it gone?
Is this Madame Tussauds?
It is, that one. So, it's not the right colour, is it?
I thought it was darker than that.
Dwayne Johnson, everyone's saying it's Dwayne Johnson mixed with Vin Diesel.
Is this in Madame Tussauds, is it? Or?
No, Paris. Grevin Paris, maybe. I don't know what that is.
Don't know.
I hope I'm saying it right there for the French. Grevin Paris.
Sounds right to me.
As long as you put a twang on it, you're all right.
Grevin.
It's probably not even an E. It's probably Grevin.
Have you seen the statue that they unveiled in America of David Beckham?
That was bad, wasn't it?
They did a black one.
Oh, right.
Before they opened his...
did you see the Ronaldo one, the black one?
No.
Oh, that's funny, yeah. The David Beckham what?
I can't remember who did it. It was James Corden when he did his Saturday Night Live.
Right. And it was a wound-up one?
Yeah. they wound him
golden
up with
balls.
It. Brilliant video.
Oh, God. Right, now I'm going to search in the Ronaldo one. That's just as bad, I'd say. And this one was a real one, not a wind-up. That's terrible. Think they like him.
It looks more like him than he does.
Yeah. Old school Ronaldo. They're all clapping at it and everything.
It looks like a comedy.
It does, doesn't it? Like a comedy sketch.
What did he say? Did he say anything about it?
He paused with it.
You couldn't.
Pauses with questionable bronze statue. You'd have to say something, wouldn't you?
The eyes are too close together.
You'd have to say something, wouldn't you? You could have just got...
I mean, look at the picture of Ronaldo there and look at the distance between his eyes on that one. He's even got lines on his eyes as well.
That's so bad. Oh, look at his teeth as well. What's
please,
going on?
Please go and look at this one, everyone. Just type in Ronaldo bad statue. Brilliant. Jesus. Absolutely brilliant.
He looks nothing like him.
It's wonky on one side. He's got one halo within the other.
Awful, and everything about it is wrong.
Is this a special version of
what?
If he was a special, this is what he'd look like if he was a special person.
See, that's more realistic. It still doesn't look like him, but it's better.
Yeah, it looks a bit better than that one.
Hang on, what's this one? That looks nothing like him either. Why can't they get statues right?
I have no idea.
Right, anyway, we're going to make another brew come first.
Yeah, we'll have another brew. Cue the music.
Okay.
Not that one, the other one.
Right, yeah. And we're back.
Hello.
Howdy. I was like, where's my mouse? Put on charger.
should be alright about that.
Still flashing. Oh, still flashing. Let's see if we can make it through the podcast. NFL is brutal straight away. This is works because the last Facebook link didn't work, did it? Showed some woman wanking off her horse by the looks of it.
Oof. Here comes the. Y'all don't really want it like. Here comes Oasis. Yeah, it is brutal.
I'm going to turn that down. So we talk through instead. It's like, I know you've got all that gear on, but
yeah, your body's still going to take some brutal.
Even in the car crash.
Yeah. You know. The thing is, though, if you look at that, and then you look at rugby players as well.
Yeah.
They've got all that padding on, which
I think that's worse than rugby.
It can be, yeah.
Rugby, I mean, you get tackles, but this seems like they're running head on
because they know they've got
waiting to catch the ball in front of them.
Yeah.
Whereas rugby play is sad on, you know where it's coming from. But that's like you're looking in the air and the next thing your head tweak off.
Yeah, is a oof. That his helmet came off as well.
Dangerous, isn't it? But apparently NFL, only one game only lasts around 14 minutes.
Yeah,
the rest of it's commercials and
they have
breaks.
You have three quarters. Everything's done in quarters. Mm. So if you...
What's that, fourth quarter?
Sorry?
Quarters in...
So they play for 15 minutes, have a break, like a timeout.
Right.
And that's where the Americans, they go to... Everything's based... All shows are based around the commercials.
Yeah.
When I went to America, I put a TV show on and you'd have the commercials and then you'd have the credits to the programme. Then the commercials would come on. Then you'd have the programme. Then you'd have the commercials like we would have. And then you'd have the show. And then you'd have the commercial. Then you'd have the end credits and then a commercial.
But at that point, that's where the BBC TV licence actually did make sense.
Yeah.
Because you're getting rid of all that. But now you pretty much watch anything on Netflix without commercials.
Yeah.
We call them commercials. Why have we got American?
I don't know. Adverts.
Adverts.
Goes to the adverts.
Yeah.
We got sidetracked then, didn't we?
We did, didn't we? Like we lost our
talking about
four.
The NFL.
Yeah.
But anyway, we've gone about a quarter, so like a play is like 15 minutes, and then you have a timeout, then you have another 15 minute timeout, and then.
Right, but even in between that, apparently it's like stop start a lot, so it's like only the game time. I'm sure it's like 14 minutes.
Yeah, they do have a lot of stop start in between in the quarters, like.
Yeah. Prankster gets shot and the shooter gets off scot-free. What do you think of that? Do you think you should be allowed to shoot a prankster?
Depends on what the prank is.
Let's see if there's a video of it. I'm sure there's a video. It's not graphic, don't worry. I know you don't like the graphic stuff.
No. I think it depends on what the prank would be.
Shooting closing down a mall in Virginia after a YouTuber allegedly tried pranking a man for a video, but then he was shot in response. That suspect now in custody.
This is 21-year-old Tanner Cook.
Do you know this guy?
A budding comedian who posts videos regularly to his channel, Classified Goons.
Welcome back to another video.
He's known for ruffling feathers.
Hey, get the hell out of here.
Sometimes to the point security or police are called. But his latest stunt was met with gunfire. When a shopper Cook was trying to prank got offended and shot him, according to Cook's family.
Went through his stomach and into his liver, and they took his gallbladder.
The Loudoun County Sheriff's Department arresting the shooter, identified as Alan Coley. Charges include aggravated malicious wounding.
Yeah, but he got off of it. He didn't get done. So I think, where'd you stand with that? I think shooting him was a bit extreme. But apparently he kept saying that, just get it in your face, instead of doing it. Give him lots and lots of warnings.
You should probably give him a lot of warnings and then thought, stuff this.
Yeah, I'm not putting up with this anymore. Because I think pranksters do take things too far sometimes.
Yeah, I think some do.
And
probably got what he deserved, really, if he was winding people up.
Winding people up and get shot. There you go. I wonder if he's still pranking after that.
Probably not.
I think he's wearing a bulletproof vest when he does it now. There's a video of an old man that shot some woman or something because he was trying to break into his house. What do you think about that? Like,
if you get the right to defend your home.
Yeah, but I think it's the way he says it. He said, I'll get the video up.
Shoots woman in back.
No regrets. Oh, killing pregnant intruder.
Oh, right.
But I think it's the way he says it.
Adrenaline increases the heart rate, blood pressure. While some fight
is sparking a lot of debate on social media right now, and you'll understand why. A Long Beach, California homeowner.
He says it like
has
I'd do it again. After type thing.
Killing an unarmed woman who said she was pregnant. This after he got into a confrontation with her and another man who were ransacking his home.
When the time comes to defend yourself, you best do something.
The words of the 80-year-old homeowner who confronted two robbers.
I walked in on them, and they downed me. They jumped on me in the hallway.
But Tom Greer says he managed to get his .22 caliber Smith & Wesson revolver. He says when that unarmed couple saw his gun, they took off out the back door, and he followed.
The lady didn't run fast as a man, so I shot her to back twice. She's dead, and they told her off, but he got away. She says, don't shoot me. I'm pregnant. I'm with a baby. And I shot her anyway.
There's been a swift and almost split reaction on social media sites. While some
Jesus
say
Christ.
They would have done...
So, if he says... It's the way he says it, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like, she says, oh, I'm pregnant, I'm pregnant. Like, I shot her anyway.
I don't care. If you're pregnant.
Yeah. You're an intruder.
Yeah. Bang.
That makes him sound bad, the way he said that.
I get what he's saying. But if he'd have just got the gun out and he supposedly fled anyway, then you've done your job.
Yeah.
You didn't need to actually shoot her because she fell over.
Yeah, but I mean, he could have even kept her there, holding a gun to her. Well, don't move, police coming for you. And then
yeah, you could have done that, yeah.
She gets arrested and
yeah.
Baby's fine then, isn't it?
Yeah.
I wonder if the baby survived. Don't know, she died, but I mean, you can get a baby after a certain time.
Don't know.
Mad. Yeah. America again.
America again.
A new pepper is the world's hottest pepper. It's called Pepper X. Heard of it? Would you eat
not
it?
Not heard of Pepper X, and probably not. The furthest I can go is jalapeno.
Oh yeah, I like an jalapeno, me. I'm obsessed with them, man.
Yeah, I like them.
It's hot, but nice.
I've got a nice little jar at home.
Have you?
Yeah.
What do you have it with?
I stick them on pizzas.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I stick them in, or sandwiches.
Yeah, on pizzas and Subways.
Nice to have that little tingle on your tongue.
I don't normally, buy a jar of them, though, because
if I go Subway, I would make sure jalapenos go on.
Oh, yeah, have you seen how much they put on?
Yeah.
It's like a full jar on one sandwich. You put loads on.
Great.
It is good.
I think that's probably the hottest I'd go.
A jalapeno?
Yeah.
It gets to a point where it's painful, isn't it? It's like... You're not even enjoying it at that point.
Exactly.
You can't even taste food anymore.
Have you seen those people who do pepper eating competitions?
No.
And they start off with the really mild stuff. And
they build
the way up to really hot. Yeah. Something. And then people pull themselves out because they've got too hot, but people carry on.
Right. Can you not just go to other way around?
Go from hottest to mildest.
Hottest. And burn your mouth up. But then all the rest are not as bad.
Well, you don't suppose. But they start off from really mild ones.
Yeah. I wonder if that's a better way to do it.
You can get on YouTube.
What is it?
Pepper eating competition.
How long is it though? It seems like it'd be long.
I don't know. Might have short ones on there.
Hot pepper competition. Oh, I suppose it runs 5 minutes. Let's have a quick look. See what happens.
They think the Carolina Reaper's the pinnacle. And this is obviously looking to be a hotter pepper than the Reaper. Can I make that assumption?
That's right. These competitors will be eating peppers that even Guinness hasn't tested yet.
Oh, this might be Pepper X. That's now the Guinness World Record.
Price, if he ever offers you anything, just say no. It's just a safer option because the chances are it's just going to light you up and then knock you down.
Oh, my. You're a bad man.
Oh, that's way different than the end.
Yeah, it is.
Way different.
I can't feel my face.
What? With his secret stash of unnamed peppers.
What do you want to call that, Ed, or have you got a name for it already?
You can call it whatever you want.
That's him. Laid out that's the one that's got Pepper X. He owns the Pepper X.
Untested, unrelenting.
And it doesn't affect him.
The biggest, hottest pepper in the arsenal.
Weighing in at a whopping 30 grams, it's as hideous as it is hot, and it takes no prisoners.
These are the hottest peppers in the world that no one's ever eaten before outside of our team.
This is the giant Carolina Reaper. SHU, get the fuck out of here.
Is a basket of petri.
That was a bit late for that one.
Given the pepper from this basket, they will have a maximum of 15 seconds to eat that pepper.
Jesus.
They can still be chewing after 15 seconds for giving that, but they must get all of that pepper in their mouth within 15 seconds.
For Sid, chewing fast isn't just a challenge, it's her Achilles heel. Why?
She's got those bad English teeth.
Hey! Whoa! Turn this off.
I can't actually bite because I've got manky teeth. I'm going to get a bag with put holes in it like this and we'll wear that on my head.
British dentistry. Living up to its reputation.
Whoa, we're getting slaughtered here, aren't we?
I'm gonna try it. Give it my best.
Fort Mill, you ready for this? 3, 2, 1, eat!
So you got 15 seconds to eat it, haven't they? Well, that's not the hard part, is it? Eating it. Surely he's like,
it's the aftermath.
The aftermath. The aftermath. Oh, he's nowhere near finished it. She's nowhere near finished it. Them bad English teeth she's got in it. Yeah. She's rubbish here.
Sid, we're not continuing the competition. Please give her a big, big cheer.
See, if you go to that, you're going to have to swallow it, and you? Otherwise, you've just ate it, and you're still in pain, but you're not in the competition anymore. Yeah. So you may as well just swallow it all.
Yeah.
Can I have a bucket?
The final titan has now fallen. And then there were two. Dark Horse versus Darker Horse.
I mean,
first person to show me a clean mouth.
I'm getting into this. We need to stop this podcast. We're watching something.
Their name will end up on a check for $1,000.
Well,
$1,000?
41 Chilli's right now.
I'm going to go back to that there, so watch that. See who wins.
Yeah, it's, they have competitions.
What competitions do you reckon you could do good at? Like, food-wise? I think I could do well in hot dog one, me.
I don't know.
I could eat loads of hot dogs, me.
I don't know. Chocolate.
Enough. Chocolate. I don't eat loads of chocolate. Yeah. It makes me feel well sick.
Yeah. Eating lots of anything makes me feel ill.
It does.
I just like a portion of whatever.
Yeah.
But then I'm known at home, I'm known as a human dustbin.
Oh, yeah.
So I always eat everyone's leftovers as right. Well.
Well, I would, but I always overdo myself. I get way too much for myself.
I sometimes overdo myself.
Yeah. Especially when I got like Mackies and stuff like that. I love this burger. I'll have the opposite. So if I get a chicken burger meal, I'll have to have like a beef burger as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
if anything like that,
if we go out anywhere or do some of that, I'm always then, I finish, and if my daughter sort of leaves half of hers, I'll eat it.
Well, yeah. Well, that's old school, isn't it? It's like you don't want to leave food behind, so yeah, I think you don't want to waste it.
That's what I do.
Yeah.
I'm the human dustbin, apparently.
Right.
According to my daughter.
See, I went to, for an Indian with like the work friends, and they're a lot older, and, you know, I was pretty much done with it. I had loads of bits of chicken left, and he said, don't leave the meat. Like, what? Don't leave the meat behind. You either eat the meat or just like give it to someone else because they'll just reuse it in the back. Don't leave meat. Like, bloody hell, it's old school, like, isn't it? It's like, I always leave meat. It's, you know, you're finished.
Yeah,
I don't care what the next person's eating.
Yeah. I like an Indian. I like a good Indian.
I like an Indian. It's probably my favourite type of food.
Like Rogan Josh, tikka masala.
Yeah. Rogan Josh, how's that?
Biryani.
Is that hot or what?
Rogan Josh, no, it's quite mild.
Is it?
Well, it is for me.
Is it vegetables and stuff in it?
I'm
always looking for a new Indian because I always do like tikka masala because that's a safe bet.
Have a go with Rogan Josh. Nice that.
Is it got a lot of sauce? I like a lot of sauce.
Yeah, there's a lot of sauce in it.
Is there?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, it depends how much you can make it with a lot of sauce anyway, but you just put it in, just put less additives in it.
Yeah, because some curries you get, it's like literally just vegetables and chicken and stuff.
Yeah.
Where's the sauce at? Like, from your rice?
Yeah, we get that. We get them from Aldi, I think.
Hmm.
It's like their version of pataks.
I've got a 4 red chilli extra hot tikka masala in the freezer. I want to try that.
Nice.
4 chilies.
4 chilies.
It's going to be hot.
I think a Rogan Josh is 3.
Is it?
I think. I'm thinking of the right one.
Alright. Oh, flat earthers attempt to...
I just read it.
Attempt to sail to the edge of the world's ends in a massive disappointment.
Of course they'd be massively disappointed.
Yeah. So they get to what they think is the end and realise, shit, it goes on.
Yeah, just carries on.
How gutty would they be?
Yeah. Fair they would.
Do you reckon at that point they thought, maybe it is round? Maybe it's...
No.
Or do you reckon they continue to... this just isn't the end then?
It just isn't the end. We're just... Obviously, Earth is so big that we just haven't got to the end.
The end of it, yeah. Definitely.
That's how probably how they think.
Yeah. It's mad, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like even when you're proven wrong, you still
you're always wrong.
Definitely.
They're always right. Because they're so convinced.
Yeah, it's a bit crazy, isn't it?
There's the Domino's. The Domino's
one's in, yeah, come on, there. 6 hours. Well, bare knuckle is brutal. Next.
We know bare knuckle's brutal.
Yeah, we've had. This is actually them fighting. This is an interview afterwards.
The state of her.
First round, I realised that she was a lot tougher than I was.
Why would you allow yourself to end up like that?
I just expected her to show a bit more tiredness. It didn't go the way I wanted, but I was still happy that I went all the 5 rounds. It may not look like it, I enjoyed the whole process.
Oh my God.
I enjoyed being in the ring and challenging.
Get a tooth knocked out.
If I fight Britt again, I think what I'd do is, although I thought I liked the fight, I backed up a little bit more than maybe I should have, and I probably tried to do other things that I wouldn't.
Oh, she's a mess, isn't she?
Absolute mess, that, isn't it?
She's been obliterated. But it's safer than like other sports like boxing and stuff.
Is it?
Yeah, because you're getting physical damage on the outside, but your brain's not getting as much damage.
Yeah.
Because you give up quicker. When boxing, your brain's just getting knocked around like a ball. Yeah. So they say internally, boxing's worse for you. It bashes you up. Orangutan retrieves crying Charles lost teddy, then rips it to shreds. That's hilarious. I watched that. Oh, that's fantastic. It looks like he's going to give it him back, though. It probably like teases the kid. It rips it over the top of the kid.
Right.
So it, I'll show you now. Proper Ash. Is that the video? Is this going to be it? After the advert, maybe. Oh, no, it's here.
Today we went to Dublin
while visiting.
While visiting the orangutans, a child dropped their teddy into the water.
Might give it back. You never know.
So just an update: the orangutan is on some rocks, and it's the teddy's fallen into
the
some
orangutan
water.
Broke off some grass and tried to get the teddy.
Well, she's telling you anyway.
Shut up, Steve.
Yeah. Probably interrupted me, didn't you? But clever, though, weren't they?
It eventually got it out, and it looked like it gave it a kiss.
It looks like it gives it a kiss. Doesn't it?
Is that the kid crying?
Yeah, for his tether.
He's taking care.
When it began to climb up, everyone thought it was going to drop it back down to the child.
It's cool and close, that, isn't it? It's an orangutan.
Imagine if
you're here. So he's all the top of them now, like.
Monkey, drop the teddy.
But instead, it ripped the teddy apart, dropping the fluff down onto the crying child.
How's that? Well, how's that?
R.I.P. Teddy.
Poor kid.
That's brutal.
Poor kid.
You're going to learn today. Yeah. Monkeys, just is it a monkey?
Orangutan.
Orangutan is a chimp.
It's an ape,
isn't it? Yeah.
Apes don't have tails.
Mm. As we've discussed on here,
we have
the Irish chimps because they're ginger. But that was in Ireland as well, so that makes sense. Cows have magnets in them.
That's what I was laughing at before.
Did you know that?
No.
So there was a big conspiracy about it, about them having like magnets inside them. And it turns out that it's true. They put magnets inside cows.
For what reason?
So from what I read, I didn't read too much into it. But apparently, it's because they get bits of metal inside them when they're on farms, and that can make them ill and kill the cows.
Right.
And this magnet stops that metal from hitting any internal organs or something.
Right.
So it's actually saving the cows by having. That's what I read up anyway. Could be wrong. do your own research on that one, but that's what I've read about it. There you go. It leaves them vulnerable to any stray piece of metal in their food from broken farm equipment. Screws, wires, fencing. But I don't get how that works. Well, at what point does the magnet stop?
I was gonna say, it's had, as they're walking along, it picks up all the things. And cows are walking around with screws and bits of farm equipment.
When I first read it, like, they've got magnets in it, I thought it was going to have like a big magnet in the back and just come along and pick them up to move them. Like a big crane or something. Pick them up by the magnet, a claw machine.
Yeah,
I didn't know that. That was weird. This split coloured lobster displays a condition known as, what's that say,
gynadromorphy.
Yeah, meaning it has half male, half female. It's extremely rare and can be seen in butterflies and other animals.
Okay.
And it said this picture, I've screenshotted the picture, it's pretty cool. Let's get it.
It's basically a half male, half female lobster.
Yeah, that's cool, isn't it? So can it like just have babies naturally itself?
I don't know.
Cool, is that?
Oh wow!
Straight in the middle.
Straight down the middle.
That's mad, isn't it? Imagine if that was like a man and a woman, like a human, but the other way around. So
yeah, you'd be arguing with yourself, wouldn't you?
So from the waist down, you've got a penis and that, and up you've got boobs and stuff, and you can build.
You'd be arguing with yourself.
You'd be arguing, yeah.
You're there trying
you
to
put yourself in the doghouse, wouldn't you?
You're there touching the boobs and you go, get off!
Yeah, yeah. I've got an headache.
I'm not in the mood.
I've got an headache. Yeah. This is going to sound bad. It might need cutting. But you know, like trans people that are changing over, you know, from, let's say, male to female.
Yeah.
And they get themselves breasts. Do you think they're like, kind of like the look of their own breasts?
Don't know.
The new breasts.
Maybe get one on.
Do you know, like,
a trans mean not a breast?
A trans that still likes women. So, like, do you know what I mean? So, from male to female, but he still likes women.
Oh, right, okay.
So, then breasts, do they look attractive to him?
Don't know.
He's all good the new, isn't
that? That's a good question, though.
It is. I didn't want to be offended, offensive to anyone. Like, but I just want to know if that would be a pretty
maybe
sight
try
to
and
you.
Get one on as a guest.
Because obviously, us men, we like the look of breasts.
We do.
And if you like female, then if I got breasts, would I like my own breasts?
Exactly. Well, that's a good question, though. It's a paradox, that, really, isn't it?
Obviously, you get used to it and it'll just become normal, but first you might like, oh, that's nicer.
Or are you going to look in the mirror and go, oh, God, that's not what I thought.
Yeah. Would you be constantly squeezing them?
I don't know.
Stress balls.
Arousing yourself.
Yeah.
Ooh.
And the same applies to the other way around, doesn't it? Like, a woman that's turned into a man, but still likes men. If she got a penis, would she like the look of a
penis? How does that work, though?
Penis? What?
A woman getting a penis?
Well, they invert it, don't they? They take your vagina out and unravel it and fill it with, like, your meat in your leg and stuff like that. It's weird. Weird surgery, isn't it?
Yeah, because, well,
and they do the
technically women.
They do the opposite to men, don't they?
In biology terms, technically women have one.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's right. What the button is, shall we say. Or the man in the boat. The bean.
Yeah, so in regards to men having it done to a vagina, then apparently your vagina can only be as long as your penis was. So if you had a micro penis and you turned trans, you'd have a really small, you'd have a micro vagina.
Right.
Is it a thing?
I don't know.
Maybe
have a look at him and try and get a guest on.
What?
Maybe try and get a trans guest on.
And which way? Ask male to female?
Either
to
or.
That one. Wrestler?
Yeah, can we get the wrestler on?
Yeah.
That'd be interesting.
It would. Yeah, we'll have a chat with them. But saying that, I'd ask questions like that and I'd probably offend them.
Well, just
I don't mean to be offensive.
Well,
I'm just curious.
Yeah, we're just curious. We don't mean to sound ignorant.
Yeah.
We're not totally understanding of this.
Yeah, I'm just trying to learn.
Yeah, we're trying to learn.
And along the way, learn more, other people. And, like, teach other people.
And teach and be more accepting of these
choices.
People.
Exactly. Where was you up to? Oh, the lobster we just done, haven't we? October 5th to October 14th in 1582, the 10 days that didn't happen.
Okay.
Well, that's interesting.
Do we know about that?
Yeah, so I'll try and explain it.
Please do.
back then, they didn't have the same calendars as what we had now. So it was a different calendar.
Right.
And when we changed to that, to readjust with everyone else's calendar, we had to skip out them 10 days. So right. them 10 days didn't happen. That's so crazy. Up to now, we'd be 10 days back if it was carried on.
Right, okay.
So what day would it be today? It'd be the 11th of October.
Right.
That's mad, isn't it?
Yeah.
I can't remember what the other calendar used to be called. It used to be called someone else, didn't it? And they changed it.
Yeah, well, it was the Romans who created the calendar.
Right. God knows what happened there then. I mean, I could probably search it up and give you more information if you want. The most surreal part of implementing the new calendar came in October 1582, when 10 days were dropped from the calendar to bring the vernal equinox. Is that right? Equinox. Yeah. From March 11th to March the 21st. The church had chosen October to avoid skipping any major Christian festivals.
Right, okay.
Right, it's always Christian related, isn't it?
The vernal equinox.
Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, there's a question there. Why were 11 days skipped in 1752?
Was it more days skipped?
By the time the discrepancy between a solar year and the Julian calendar, which was the Roman one, had grown by an additional day. So the calendar used in England and its colonies was 11 days out of sync with the Gregorian calendar used in most other parts of Europe.
Right, so we changed again.
Yeah.
Later on.
Yeah.
So which way did that go? 11 days out, so we went forward more or all back? 11 days was skipped. So that's 21 days so far from 50. That means we're still on that last month. Yeah. 21st today.
Happy birthday again.
Yay! Got some presents for you.
Yeah. Hang on.
Russell.
Oh, I got all excited then.
Yeah. Just a Blue Nation t-shirt. Yeah. I'm not putting up wall yet.
Yeah, I was going to say, we need to get more guests on, don't we? Because we need to start filling this wall again.
Yeah, yeah. Let's see if Abby Flynn will send a picture. We've got some frames ready to put up.
I'm sure she'll send us one.
Yeah. Right.
I'll have a listen to some of Abby Flynn on my way home.
Yeah, it's good. Well, I'll put one of her songs on now. Just a little bit, so I don't get done for copyright, but... let's have a look. There's one that I like. It's a massive dance song, but she's done an acoustic version of it, and it's good. She does loads of different types of music as well. She likes a lot of soul music as well. I think that's what she started off on.
Don't you think like that, I will love you endlessly. If you'd only believe me, don't you be like that, I will love you endlessly. Oh, don't go and ruin the vibe now.
And I'll stop it there so we don't get copyright. I think you can do that 30 seconds. So. Yeah, can't wait to have her on.
It's not a bad voice, that.
That's a great voice, isn't it? But that's like a really popular dance song, but that's her acoustic version of it. And, yeah. I want to ask why her name's not on the main song. Like, are they paired her out? Like, what?
I don't know. Because you usually see something like, I don't know, Get Fact featuring.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I mean. But she's not on that, on the main DJ's song.
In the agreements of the song, maybe.
I'd love to ask her why. Like, Did he just pay her out, or what? Does she still get money from that?
Royalties, maybe. I don't know
because her name's not on it. Yeah, but I noticed that every dance song that Becky Hill's in, she's on it. Her name's on it.
I wonder if she's got
a lot of Abby's new songs. She is actually in them songs. Like,
so it's her earlier stuff.
That song was from 2021, and she's not on that, but she is on that.
Right, okay.
So maybe. To ask. Yeah, I'd be intrigued to find out. Health and safety in the 1980s. Here we go. This should be fun.
Wasn't as rigid as it was today.
I can't remember what this is.
Wasn't as rigid as it was today.
I don't know if it's a video. Oh, it's a video. I do remember what it is. Bad this.
Was Reg to sell?
Hello, Rich.
Hey, you
pleased to meet you.
This is Terry. And
I remember
Terry.
This.
What's Terry?
You do.
And yep. Terry.
And you're
remember,
going up.
I remember right? watching this. Oh,
you're wow. going to show me how to do it, are you?
I'll try.
Yep.
This is what we call a bosun's chair. Yeah. Okay, look, if you look over the side.
Yeah.
Not very big, is it?
Well, it's big enough for you, I think.
Whereas nowadays they have scaffolding.
Do I wear a harness as well?
Well, just you don't on, like, need to. Wooden
it's
plank.
Quite safe.
Yep.
With rope.
Okay.
It's quite safe.
That's scary,
if
isn't
I get over
it?
The side, I'll show
There's
you
another
how to
one.
Do
it.
All right, you show it then.
Hang on.
Okay. Right. This is
what?
There's another one if you after you've done this bit, if you go to, what was his name? Guy, and he used to be a chimney
sweep guy.
And he'd climb up, no dismantle chimneys.
Oh, right.
He'd climb up literally with just ladders on the side of a massive chimney.
Yeah.
Fred Dibner.
Look at that, how high it is, though.
Yeah.
And then, have you seen the rope?
Yeah, which is called a club.
That's how you load himself down.
Okay.
Yeah. Just and a piece of rope, I think.
You wouldn't lower yourself down, you just slacken it off. Yeah. Lower it, about 6 inches.
That's terrifying.
You saw how I got over there. You can do the same. Get this cocky leg right.
I won't
over.
Be doing that, even back then.
Get that in there like that. That's it. This one over.
No hands.
Just hold on to there.
It's a big bend for the fifth time in 15 years.
Yeah.
That is scary. That's not long ago, that was it, 1980s.
1980. Well, it was about 40 years ago.
43 years. That's nothing.
And that was
how much changed in 43 years?
Whereas now you'd have all scaffolding up and
that's what I made a joke about that in work the other day, saying like babies nowadays like come out with like steel toe cap boots on.
Oh yeah,
health and safety's gone mad.
And a big bubble wrap. Have a look at Fred Dibner.
Well, there's that famous painting, isn't there, of the scaffolding people that are just sat on the bar having the food.
Yeah, when they built wanted to do it, is it?
So high up and just sat there on a big beam.
Like, what's that big building in America? I can't remember what it's called.
Yeah.
Yeah, and when they were building that, they sat on having lunch.
Yeah. I wouldn't like to be on the end. Like the first one out. That's furthest away, isn't it? I'd like to be the closest so I can just grab the wall if I fall or something.
Yeah.
I mean, if you fall back, you're gone.
Yeah.
There's nothing. Yeah. Not even touched by a rope. Has that made us soft with all this health and safety, do you reckon?
Yeah, I think it has.
You reckon?
Yeah.
Because that stuff we didn't think about back then.
Yeah, because I think it was just as many accidents then as there is now.
Yeah.
Probably even more now, to be honest.
We're just a bit more scared of doing things without protection.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But if you have a look at Fred Dibner was funny. He'd literally just climb up the side of a ladder with some rickety owl. Side of a chimney, sorry.
Yeah. Fred
Dibner.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at the video there.
That video, yeah?
Yeah.
So you used to what? Climb up chimneys and do what?
It had fascinated me through my childhood. Oh, the elders, one little man get all that up.
He's not attached by any ropes or anything, just a ladder that he's fixed up himself.
He's from Wigan, him.
Like, if you went to talk to
I think so.
He's from Wigan, isn't he?
Really explain in language I understood how you did it, because I don't think they really knew themselves. You know, they'd just left school and been shown, the way to do it, and they battered at it in a wild sort of a fashion.
He says the day Bolton stood still, so maybe he's from Bolton.
And life very went by, and accent. One day I met the man who sort of had been a draftsman. And he'd only ended up in this crazy job through his father-in-law were a bit stuck, who were a steeplejack, and he'd gone help him out, and he were like a bit of a cut above the rest with the grey matter, and he explained to me with a piece of chalk on the cobblestones in a mill yard in Bolton how you put the ladders up and how you put the staging up round top of a chimney.
I love that accent, me.
That's how she's going to understand it.
It just reminds me of home. It's weird. That is, everyone talks like that.
Somewhere
from
round about here, on me three bits of rope and a little board. I have then got to chisel four holes into the brickwork, 6 inches apart, in a vertical plane and a couple of foot apart.
I want to see where he's from, because he sounds Wigan more than Bolton to me. Lancashire.
Bolton.
Lancashire town of Bolton. Eh? Papa sounds that Wigan though.
Well, it says there on the side, from the foothills of the West Pennine Moors, Bolton is between Manchester, Blackburn, Wigan, and Bury. Salford, and is surrounded by several towns and villages. So you've all got the same accent.
Ah, we've not, though. Where would you class Warrington as then? Merseyside, is it?
It's Warrington's Cheshire.
Is it Cheshire?
Yeah.
Right. And where are you from?
I used to live in Runcorn.
All right. That's Merseyside, isn't it?
No, it's Cheshire.
That's Cheshire as well?
Yeah.
Right. So have they got like rough Scouse accents then?
Because a lot of them came from Liverpool.
Yeah.
The overspill.
They shipped over.
Yeah.
The overspill. Oh yeah, it's now okay to feed ducks bread again. Oh,
make up your minds.
Yeah, it got banned, didn't it? Saying like you're killing the birds.
Yeah.
But apparently more ducks are now dying because people are not feeding them the bread. They're all starving.
Well, we got told not to feed them because it has no nutritional value to them. Right. So they're just eating it and they're filling up, but it has no nutritional value to them. So if you want to feed them, get proper food, and you get like peas, like you can throw peas down and you know, other bits and pieces, just not bread. Now they're saying
they're saying feed them bread.
So is that because it does have nutritional value?
Yeah, it must do because it's just filling them up. Like it fills us up.
Yeah,
it doesn't have much nutrition to us either, but we could pretty much live off bread because it's got something in it.
You know what they say, you can live on bread and water.
Yeah. So
is that buttered bread or water?
So go and get your bread, your spare bread, and go and feed the ducks. Go and feed the ducks. Save the world bit by bit. 40% of American kids believe hot dogs grow on trees.
Oh my God. Why would
40%?
You Why would you grow up believing that?
That's a lot, isn't it? 40% of American kids.
Exactly, American kids.
Yeah.
That's probably like the South, Mid-South.
Hot dogs.
Brandane.
Is that because of little crinkles on anything that's where maybe a plant was old in it or something? I've never heard that before.
Is this where Brandane and Cletus live?
Now
Brandane, she's your mama too.
But it's meat. Straight off.
Well, I know. So, unless it's got anything to do. Have you seen them plants that look like hot dogs?
Oh, yeah.
They grow out. Anything to do with that?
Maybe.
I used to joke around with friends saying, look, there's the hot dogs there.
Oh, because it's got all things corn dogs.
Corn dogs.
Corn. Is a sort of veg in it.
I don't know.
Maybe they get mixed up with that. Yeah. So I wonder. I'm curious to see what UK kids. I don't think any kids would believe they're growing.
I don't think. I can't see any UK kids thinking.
I'll search in the same thing and change it to American.
There is. Sorry.
That's American, I think. Oh, is that?
About 40 people. Hang on. A recent study published in the Journal of Environmental Psychology found that a disturbing portion of children between the ages of 4 and 7 don't know where their food comes from. The authors say their data demonstrates that about 40% of kids think bacon, hot dogs and chicken nuggets come from plants. Where's the parents in this?
I know, like the chicken nuggets, I mean, you can get them, you know, plant-based ones.
I get that, and that's...
Yeah.
But bacon...
It's a bit weird, isn't it? Bacon hanging off a tree, imagine that. That would be weird, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Bacon tree.
It would be weird. And that's all I've got wrote down for today. I think we should maybe finish with ChatGPT news.
ChatGPT.
Cue the music.
Cue the music.
There once was a man who found something gross in his KFC meal that he ordered to go. He looked at his chicken and saw a big worm, and he made a face that was quite full of scorn. There was a woman who saw in a tree the face of a character from Disney. She took a picture and showed it online, and people agreed they looked like Simba. There once was a dad who came home one day and found that his lawn had been taken away. Someone had stolen his grass in the night, and he was left with a patchy brown sight. That's all for ChatGPT news. Over to you, Stu. That's all I've got.
A lot of them sounded like limericks.
I know, yeah, they did. Poems, yeah. Because it's going to be like weird ones. He's got like funny news of the week. Verse 1. Some thieves thought they had a great plan. They stole some portable toilets from a van, but they didn't know what they were getting into because those toilets were full of human poo. What are they? What's that?
So they stole some portable toilets, didn't they?
Yeah.
They obviously haven't been emptied.
Right. But they, what, why are they in songs for?
I know, I don't get
it. I'm going to give this a go. A woman was walking and saw something odd. A tree that looked like a lion cub. She snapped a photo and posted it online, and people said it was a sign. It's a new segment, isn't it? I don't know. That's different than normal, that. Weird.
Weird.
Weird chat GPT today it was. A very weird one. Do you want to grab a fact book and like give us a few facts to see us out in that?
Well, I've got some facts here.
Oh, have you? Because yeah. I didn't know you brought any, so... Okay, brilliant. Fantastic. Always prepared.
It's right down your road as well, Steve.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I don't mean literally your road.
All right. Full of bottles.
Viking facts.
Oh, yeah. Tell me more.
I've not got my glasses, so bear with me. Jack, I'm trying to talk. The term Viking refers to the Norse seafarers, traders, and warriors who lived during the Age of Vikings, which spanned from the late 8th to the early 11th century. Vikings originated from the Scandinavian region, including modern-day Norway, Sweden, and Denmark. You put me off. I'm trying to read, I can't see. They were skilled shipbuilders and navigators known for their long ships that allowed them to explore the and raid distant lands.
Right.
These are stuff that you already know, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Vikings are not just brutal warriors. They had complex society and engaged in trade, agriculture, and craftsmanship. They were skilled metal workers producing intricate jewellery, weapons, and tools.
I'd be curious to know what jewellery they made. I wouldn't mind getting some of that.
Viking jewellery.
Mm-hmm.
Have a look online. Norse mythology played a significant role in Viking culture. They worshipped gods such as Odin, Thor, and Freya, and believed in an afterlife filled with feasting and battles. Vikings were known for their trading expeditions across Europe and beyond. They established trade routes and had trading posts as far as Constantinople, which is modern-day Istanbul, and Baghdad. I didn't realise they went down to Baghdad.
Yeah, I think that was on...
came across to us.
I think that was on Vikings as well, that they went to like the entire places.
All right, okay.
Like India and stuff like that. It's mad.
I've not watched that.
I mean,
I'll have to watch it.
Oh, you never watched Vikings? Yeah. Oh, it's fantastic. It's good. Do you like Game of Thrones?
I never watched. I didn't really like that.
See, that was a bit more. We've got dragons and that, yeah. But this Vikings, it's more real.
Right,
okay. The timeline's slightly different on Vikings because like Ragnar's brother, that wasn't. That it didn't happen like that. It was like different frame, like different time frames.
Women had more rights and freedoms in Viking society compared to other cultures of the time. They could inherit property, divorce, and participate in trade and governance.
Right.
See? Forward-thinking society, that, a forward-thinking society.
Yeah. Yeah.
Norse explorers such as Leif Erikson are believed to have reached North America before Christopher Columbus. They established settlements, notably Vinland, possibly present-day Newfoundland and Canada.
Yep. That is being confirmed true now, I believe, because I'm sure they found some Viking parts in America.
All right, okay.
So that confirms that it was there before Columbus.
Ooh.
But they're just like adventuring, aren't they? The Vikings, they're like going, finding new places that could just basically take over.
Mm. Like here.
Yeah.
The Viking age declined with the Christianization of Scandinavia, which led to a decline in raiding activities and the integration of Norse societies into the larger European feudal system.
Feudal?
Mm.
What type of word's that?
Feuds.
Like feudal.
Fight, feud. Right. Feud. These are just a few fascinating facts about Vikings. The Viking Age left a lasting impact on the world history, and their tales continue to captivate our imaginations today.
It does. It does indeed.
It does with our Steve.
It does, yeah. Oh, that's it.
He's got his axe.
Yep. Not that I know he'd throw it, but... Not very good. Yeah, and that's our little fact segment there. We can't do fact off today. I want to go against you, because we've not gone against each other yet, have we?
We haven't, no.
Me against you. But we need a judge, so... Yeah. That's all I've got for today. We've done more than enough anyway, so
things haven't been too bad.
Nice, yeah, it's been a nice good little morning session. Yeah, yes, to start the day,
like a little coffee morning.
Yeah, my mouth's working now. Yeah. So if you've got anything you want to talk about, I say it all the time, I don't get any emails anymore, but our email is contact@getfact.co, and our website is www.getfact.co for all the episodes. The next episode comes out, well, there's no point saying this, is there? Because by the time I say tomorrow,
it'll be today.
I'm not doing that again. So yeah, get over there and listen to all the episodes. Thanks for listening.
And keep in touch.
And keep it coming. Yeah. Get in touch, yeah. If you'd like to fact off against us, email us.
Ooh, that'd be good.
Mm. And we'll get you on. Yeah, and we look forward to our guest next week, Abby Flynn. Can't wait to talk to her.
Yeah, that'd be interesting.
Yeah, big guest. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
It's a goodbye from me.
And it's goodbye from him. Yeah.